Hello and welcome back to Accounting Information Systems here at UMGC. I am your host, Dr. B. We are in the fourth week of our course together, and I hope that you are all enjoying our course together so far. And this week, we will talk about how accounts receivables and accounts payables interface with accounting information systems. Very important concepts because we need to know how to collect payment from our customers, and we also need to know how to pay our bills to our vendors, and how the technology of accounting information systems interfaces with those activities. And just as we talked about last week, we will quickly talk about again the concepts of the revenue cycle and the expense cycle, which are, of course, the foundation for permitting the accounts receivable and accounts payable systems within accounting information systems. So let's go ahead and recap what we talked about last week with respect to the revenue and expenditure cycles. So as we had discussed last week, the revenue cycle, of course, is the process by which we record revenue generated from the sales of goods and services provided by our company to our customers, in which we track the transaction of the sale or of the goods or services and ultimately the receipt of payment from our customers. And of course, the process by which we have delivered the good or the service and received the payment. That of course is the revenue cycle in a general sense. Representing it graphically, we receive the order from the customer, we process the order, we issue billing an invoice, we deliver the goods or the services. The goods or services are received by the customer. The customer then, of course, pays us. And then we go through the process again. With respect to expenses, this is how we track the payment for goods and services that we, the company, have received from our vendors. Or suppliers. And through this, we record the receipt of the bill for the goods or services that we have received. We record the bill, we record the payment, and then we send the payment to our vendors for the receipt of goods and services to the company. This, of course, is a representation of the expense cycle. We see how the expense cycle interfaces with the revenue cycle, inventory, other departments, the production cycle. We also see how the expenditures interface with our vendors and the general ledgers and reporting system. Now that we have a good understanding of the foundation of the revenue and expense cycles, we need to examine how these cycles interface with accounting information systems. So as you know, accounts receivable is defined as when we sell goods or services to our customer, they have received the goods or the services, and they have not yet paid us for the goods or the services. That creates what we call an accounts receivable. It is a claim to the asset, cash, which is in the possession of our customer. The customer will then pay us the asset, the cash, in exchange for the goods or the services that they have already received. We expect to receive payment from our customers at some point in the future after we have provided the good or the service. That's what creates an accounts receivable. The accounts receivable, as you know, is considered to be a short-term asset, or what we call a current asset, that we expect to collect within 1 year or less. That is an accounts receivable. Now, I'd like to show you how accounts receivable works with respect to an accounting information system like QuickBooks. How does QuickBooks account for accounts receivable? And this short video will show you how that works.
QuickBooks has many methods for tracking what your customers owe you. Anytime you enter an invoice or a payment from a customer, QuickBooks alters the accounts receivable balance for that customer. You can observe the accounts receivable balance for your entire company by clicking Accounting to open the chart of accounts. In the Assets section of the chart of accounts, you have an account named Accounts Receivable, and this balance right here represents the total amount of money that is owed to you by your customers. This balance is useful, but you normally want to see a customer-by-customer breakdown of the balance. To get that, click Sales, and then Customer. Right up here at the top of the screen, QuickBooks tells us that we have open invoices in the amount of the accounts receivable balance. But if we click on that amount and then scroll down, we can then see which customers owe us money. And if you added up all of these open balances together, you would get to this total amount. This list is good if you need to see at a glance who owes you money and how much, but it doesn't give you any aging information. To get that, go to the Report Center. And there are two reports that you can use to see the aging information for your customers' invoices. They're both on the Who Owes You section of the Report Center. And the first is the Accounts Receivable Aging Summary Report. This report shows you who owes you money. And it also shows you how much of their balance is current, so not overdue, as well as aging information from 1 to 30 days overdue, 31 to 60 days overdue, and so on. There's also a total for each customer over on the far right and a total for aging period down at the very bottom. If you need to zoom into any one of these numbers to see the actual invoices themselves, simply click on them, and here you can see the individual invoices. Another report that's useful for tracking who owes you money and whether or not they're overdue is the Accounts Receivable Aging Detail Report. This report gives you largely the same information, but instead of being grouped by customer, it's instead grouped by aging period. So here you can see all of the invoices that are between 31 and 60 days overdue, as well as a total amount for those invoices. And then all the invoices that are 1 to 30 days past due, and a subtotal for those invoices, and then the invoices that are current. Use all of these various methods to determine what your customers owe you and whether or not they're overdue on their invoices.
Excellent. So from that video, we can see how accounts receivable interfaces with an accounting information system like QuickBooks. We can see that from the generation of an invoice that we sent to a customer, how that invoice impacts the data that we can gather from the accounting information system. Being able to drill down into various reports like the aging report is very helpful. And we can also see information like how much of our sales has been on credit, meaning accounts receivable. We can see the percentage of sales to accounts receivable, percentage of sales to cash, et cetera. All of that information is very, very helpful to the business, because we can more effectively manage our cash flow from that type of information. And that's just one of the many ways how accounts receivable interfaces with an accounting information system like QuickBooks. Now, of course, I would like to show you what it looks like from the accounts payable perspective. As you know, accounts payable is generated anytime that the company owes money to anyone for any reason. It is a short-term debt, commonly to creditors or suppliers. This short-term debt represents bills that we have received based off of the receipt of goods and services from our vendors, and we have not yet paid them. That is what accounts payable means. And so to that end, it's important that we understand how accounts payable interfaces with the accounting information system, like QuickBooks. And commonly, the way it works is we receive the bill, we enter the bill into the accounting information system, and we can see various reports based off of that information. It tracks when the bills are due, and it tells us the amount, who it's due to, etc. And I will show you a very short video on accounts payable within QuickBooks.
QuickBooks tracks the amount of money you owe your vendors with an account named Accounts Payable. You can look at your accounts payable balance by going to your chart of accounts or your balance sheet and then looking at the accounts payable balance right here. You can also see a breakdown of that accounts payable balance by vendor by clicking Expenses, Vendors, and then scrolling down. Here we can see all of the vendors that we owe money to and our accounts payable balances with them. Finally, you can run reports that tell you not only how much money you owe each of your vendors, but whether or not you're overdue on any of those open bills. To run those reports, go to Reports and then scroll down to the What You Owe section. From here, you can open the Accounts Payable Aging Summary and Accounts Payable Aging Detail Reports. Between the two of these reports, the Accounts Payable Aging Summary report is the one that most people run. From here, you can see each one of the vendors that you owe money to, as well as the balance on all of the bills that you are current on, and then the balance of all the bills that you are late between 1 to 30 days on, 31 to 60 days, 61 to 90 days, and also 91 days and over. This report gives you a total by aging period and also by vendor. Finally, you can zoom in and see what transactions make up these totals by clicking on any one of the numbers, and here QuickBooks will show you the specific bill that you owe money on. The Accounts Payable Aging Detail Report gives you similar information, but it can sometimes be more difficult to read because there's more data on it, and it's organized in a different way. This report organizes all of your bills by aging period. So here you can see all of your bills that are 61 to 90 days overdue and 1 to 30 days overdue, as well as all of your current bills and then the totals for each one of these aging periods. Use all of these methods to track how much money you owe and who you owe that money to.
So as we've seen from that video, the information generated within the accounting information system based off of our accounts payables is very useful to the business because the information tells us how much we owe, who we owe it to, when it's due. We can generate various reports, such as the aging report, such as the expense, the expenses that have been paid with accounts payable, etc. There is a lot of great data that we can generate based off of our accounts payable. And those are the ways that accounts receivable and accounts payable interface with accounting information systems. So hopefully you're able to put those concepts together. We talked about the revenue and expense cycles, and we talked about how accounts receivable and accounts payable interface with the accounting information systems. Now, since we are in the fourth week, you have a couple of things going on this week. You have discussions and you also have an assignment. So the discussion for this week has to do with, of course, accounts receivable and accounts payable as an interface using accounting information systems. The prompt is about the best practice for these functions and explain how your best practice will improve the company's operations as well as many potential challenges regarding the implementation of the best practice. I want you to think about how accounts receivable and accounts payable interface with accounting information systems and how you can make improvements to those systems to improve the firm's overall operations. Think about things like cash flow, the type of information that we can see based off the reports generated from accounts receivable and accounts payable, and how cash flow ultimately improves operations. And so that will be the discussion for this week. And with respect to the homework this week, we have the career exploration assignment, which is a staple of our undergraduate accounting program here at UMGC. There are three sections to this paper. First is career goals. Second is a review of UMGC career services. And of course, the third is a review of the accounting and finance forum. The paper is about 3 pages in length. Please follow APA guidelines and standard writing requirements. You'll be able to see all of those requirements as you examine the assignment information. And as always, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns, you need any help with anything, please feel free to reach out to me. You can email me, call me, set up office hours, whatever it takes. I'm here for you 100% of the time. I want to first and foremost thank all of you for all of your efforts in the class so far. And I want you to please stay safe, wash your hands, do the right things, and I'll see you all again next time. Thank you all so much for your time today. Appreciate all of you. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.